I'm sitting here today with one of England's greatest ever footballers, Stan Matthews. In a career lasting well over 30 years, he thrilled crowds all over the country and all over Europe, playing on the wing for Stoke City, Blackpool and England. Today he's going to share some of his memories with us. First of all, Stan, can you tell us a little bit about where and when you were born?
Yes, I was born in Henley, Stoke-on-Trent, in 1915.
And how many brothers did you have?
I had three brothers, two older than me and then younger than me.
And your father was a sporting celebrity in his own right?
Yes, he was a boxer, actually. I think he fought about 115 fights. I think he only lost four, and he was very, very keen on fitness and discipline, and he taught me so many things.
Yeah.
Those days, of course, when I was young, I knew nothing about fitness and so on, but when I look back through him, learning all that experience, it kept me in very, very good stead.
Can you tell us a little bit about the way he trained you to be a young athlete?
He was tough, I suppose, but you know, in those days you left school at 14 and I was a schoolboy international at 13 and a half, and then Stoke City came, as a matter of fact, that he says you're going to sign on for Stoke City, and now that you're going to work in the dressing room, cleaning up the boots and so on, now you've got to be up every morning at 6 o'clock to do your exercises. And he said, I'm going to get you up, and eventually you'll have to get up yourself. And I thought to myself, I don't know what this is for, but remember in those days that if your father told you to jump into the river, you had to. So therefore, also he said, now, it's 2 miles from home to the Stoke City ground. You have to walk there, you have to come back for your lunch, go back again, and that meant altogether 8 miles a day. I'm not going to give you any bus money, only when it snows. So I was brought up discipline, and it was really, it was fantastic, really.
And it was a hard life for a young apprentice in those days, was it?
Well, it was. Well, I don't know if it was hard, because remember, a youngster in those days always wanted to play for his club. And the ambition of a young player, a schoolboy, was this: play for your own club, play for England, and then win a cup finals medal. That was the three things which every young kid in my area wanted.
Can you tell us a bit about your debut for Stoke when you were still very young?
Yes, well, when I was 15, you know, working on the ground there in the dressing room, I played two games in the reserves, which I suppose was a big feat. But remember in those days, there was lots of players playing at 16 and lots of players playing for... I remember a player played for Everton, played when he was 16 in the first team. And it was so different that when I was 16, then I was still an amateur, I played 22 games, and then when I was 17, I turned pro. And then when my first game as a professional 17 was against a team called Bury, at Bury, and we won 1-0.
Right. Did you score or set up the goal?
No, I didn't score. But the funny thing about it, I did centre the ball and they scored from it.
Yeah.
I only remember the nice things.
Right. Yeah,
never remember the bad games I played.
When you were that age, Stan, who did you look up to as a footballing hero? Who were the big names?
Well, in the big names, there's Alec James, there's Dixie Dean, the great centre forward of Everton. And there were so many great names in those days. And, of course, I played against when I was about 17, against Dixie Dean. But Alec James, Arsenal, in those days, they had a wonderful team. Oh, great. They were the number one team in those days.
Yeah. When you became a seasoned international, you earned a lot of praise, especially for your dribbling skills as an outside right. Was that something in your game that you developed early on? Were you known as the wizard of the dribble at an early age?
Well, I don't know how I dribble, tell you the truth. Remember when I started 17, when I was in the first team at 17 and 18, I used to score goals. Mm-hmm. I did, really. Yeah. And never entered me to try to provide goals. And then it was only later when I became very closely marked.
Yeah.
Then I decided in those days there was no coaching what you shouldn't do and what you should not do. I decided then that I must play a bit deeper, mm-hmm. and that means to say if I play deeper, the fullback won't follow me.
Mm-hmm.
So therefore, I created my own movements from there, that yeah. on the wing then.
Okay.
Getting myself space.
Yeah. That sounds like you were quite ahead of your time in that sense of playing that way.
Yeah, I think so. And then the whole point about it, funny enough, I got in the habit, I didn't like scoring goals. Mm-hmm. I never got any enjoyment. If I scored a goal, and if it was a winning goal, I wouldn't get any enjoyment out of it.
Really?
I prefer to give it to one of my colleagues. Yeah.
Setting up.
Yeah, I'd love to do that.
Yeah, okay. Before you broke through in football, how did you get on at school? Were you academically minded?
No, I was really, but you know, I used to play cricket too as the captain of my school.
Yeah.
As a wicketkeeper and a batsman, and then I also played golf. When I was 18, I was a scratch golfer.
Really?
We used to play golf quite a lot, and I was mad. Anything which was a little ball attracted me. Mm-hmm. Golf. Snooker, when I used to play snooker, but I was only fairly good, I think, at that. But tennis, yes. I think I could, if we had facilities like they do today, mm-hmm. indoor tennis courts in the winter, mm-hmm. when you had nothing to do, I think I could have played tennis too.
Yeah. So football was lucky you went down that road instead of...
Yeah, I loved the game. Football. I loved the ball. Oh, I used to treat it like something which was wonderful.
Yeah, uh-huh. How much of your skill was down to practice when you were a boy?
Well, I think from early age, as I said, because I played for my school, Wellington Road, in those days, in the first team when I was 11 years of age. But remember, I was practicing every evening without me knowing, against the wall.
Mm.
And in the winters, we used to have the gas light, you know, and I used to play underneath there.
Mm-hmm.
So. I think those were the days, and also playing with this little ball, which was so important.